Hi guys, and welcome back to SITENG. Today's video is a first from the pile caps video covering the drawings, and in today's video we're gonna have a look at the pile cap, the foundation layout. Also we're gonna have a look at the basement slab drawing, we're gonna have a look at the drainage as well, and the last one gonna be the pile cap detailed drawing. So yeah guys, let's go. So today guys is the first video covering the pile caps here, my construction site video about the pile caps. And in today's video I'm going to show you the few drawings, but actually I'm going to do it different way, different to what I was doing with the capping beam. And the reason for it is, first of all, I'm going to let you download these drawings yourself. Within 2 or 3 weeks you're going to be able to download this, you're going to have a look yourself, you're going to go all through this revisions, all this stuff, legend. So I'm not going to be wasting time showing you this now, unless this will be very important for our pile caps. And the other reason is also I didn't see the big interest in the video about the drawings, so I want you actually to leave the comments to tell me how you want this, if you prefer this way, or maybe the last bit about the capping beam was better than this. So I actually want to engage a little bit more with you as well, so I'm going to create a group when we can discuss stuff and things like this about the drawings, after you're going to obviously download them and have a look yourself. So I'm gonna have 4 drawings here. I got a pile cap layout drawing here, the foundation plan. I got also the basement slab drawing here. It's the basement slab. I have also the drainage drawing and the pile caps detail. And I cannot imagine doing anything with the ground walls without them 4 drawings, guys. So this is very important. And obviously in the next video, I'm gonna cover the rebar and maybe other services and all interesting stuff about the pile caps. So I probably gonna keep it in 2 videos. So but anyway, let's go. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna take a look at the few pile caps here, and I'm gonna explain you how I'm getting the information, and we're gonna have a look at them. So we're not gonna be wasting too much time on all the drawing, but just to make it, I'm gonna insert maybe some blank page here. Yeah, I got it here, that's fine. And I'm gonna move this bit here. So I'm gonna be interesting from grid line A11 to grid line A13. I'm gonna take this few pile caps and I'm gonna put them here on this drawing, and we're gonna have a look, we're gonna prepare like a small drawing for ourselves. And I'm gonna copy this here. So I'm gonna take same bit from the drawing here covering the basement slab. So I'm gonna get it here quickly, and we're gonna have a look. Yeah, it's here. And the drainage, of course, drainage as well, very important. So I'm gonna take this bit and we're gonna have a closer look at this, guys. So as I was always saying, wherever we're gonna construct, whatever we're gonna be doing, we want to know what's happening below us, below the elements we're doing. So I would put it as a drainage, the level we are working at. So that's gonna be our pile caps here. And what's going on, what's happening above us, above the elements we're doing. So that would be the basement slab here. So drainage, pile caps, and the basement slab. Obviously the drainage might be probably going to be doing at the same time as the pile caps, a little bit later, or some bits might be done before. But about the drainage, I'm going to tell you in separate videos, and as this is big part of works, and this requires maybe more time to do it. So I maybe put it quickly here. That's the drainage layout here. Drainage layout. Maybe make it a little bit bigger. Drainage layout, yes. So that's our drainage layout. That's our pile caps layout, and that's our basement slab here. I'm just going to put it here quickly. Basement slab, and this is actually maybe not layout, and this is actually just basement slab GA, let's say. So yeah, we got this information. We're gonna have a closer look. So you know, we got some 2 pilers, 3 pilers, and 4 pilers here. And just to quickly let you know about the notation, which is in most drawings all the same. PC2, that stands for 2 piler. So PC2, 2 piles. PC3, 3 piles. PC4, 4 piles. So that's very simple notation. Obviously, there might be difference between the pile caps, and that's the reason why we're gonna go here to pile cap detail drawing, and I'm gonna quickly show you here. So we had here, I'm gonna actually copy this there as well. We're gonna prepare all the drawings for you. So you're gonna see we got the two piler here, we had the three piler there as well. I'm gonna copy it quickly here, three piler, and we had also a four piler, which is this one. I'm gonna copy here and I'm gonna paste it here, so we got this all information on the one drawing. I'll maybe make it a little bit bigger for ourselves, and we're gonna start getting information. So maybe just going back quickly to the detail here, what I said before, it might be different depth of the pile caps and they might be a little bit different, even if it's a three piler or two piler. I think this is a good example here, showing you the PC2, the plan view, which is a 900 wide pile cap, and in this case PC2A, it's a 1200 pile cap. So that's a very important thing, guys. You need to be careful, so you're not going to mix them together. You're not going to put actually the PC2 in place of PC2A. So that's the stuff, this is important thing, but probably going to be columned this way. That's the reason for it, but that's the small things you need to keep an eye all the time. And you see the three piler here, this is a 1400 deep pile cap here, so they might be a little bit bigger, a little bit smaller, but they also might be different in the height of the pile cap itself. So that's the stuff we need to have a look at. Okay guys, so going back to here, on the drainage layout drawing here, we know now we're gonna have some pipes going through the concrete, through our pile cap. So that this designer actually shows this quite all right. I'm very happy with this. And if you're gonna be the man to order the steel, then you need to look at these drawings very closely and order the pipes as well. Because if you're gonna have a look at the pile caps instead, you can miss it. You can miss the information. And on the basement as well, you got the columns here, but you can miss the information. Despite, you can see there are gonna be some pop-ups here. You need to keep them three drawings from the very beginning to the very end all the time and get the information from. So guys, I'm gonna go now quickly to the information we need. So obviously we need a position and we need the levels, and that will be the very first information needed from us as engineers. So I'm gonna go back to the pile cap layout drawing and I'm gonna try to get this information. And as you can see here, I got it all top of pile caps to be 42,715. So that's very good. We're gonna copy this. And what I can tell you, I'm very happy. So this is very good for us. The designer made it easy for us, really, to make all the pile caps at the same level. So all the top of concrete for the pile caps gonna be 42,715, which is very good. But now we need to look at the basement slab drawing, and we need to make sure how far we're gonna go with them pile caps to our slab. If it's gonna be under the soffit, it's gonna be to the soffit, or might be this gonna be in the basement slab actually. So we're gonna go here and we're gonna try to find this information. And yes, we have here 300 RC slab, structural slab level 43,015. So now we know actually that our 42,715, this is actually soffit of the slab. So I'm gonna go back to here and I'm gonna put it here, guys. That's gonna be easy for you to see. Make it a little bit bigger maybe. And now we know that all pile caps for this building, they're gonna go just up to the soffit of the slab, which is gonna be pouring pile caps all the way to the top. We're gonna need the position of the pile caps as well. So about the position here, as you can see on this layout, there is no position given on the drawing, but there is a quite nice note here. All pile caps to be set out concentric to associated column unless dimensioned otherwise. So now we know here, we're gonna have to go to the column setting out, which is actually found on the basement slab GA, and this is going to determine the position of our pile caps. So that's very important. And also, if some pile is going to be a little bit off, obviously you need to make sure that the pile cap itself going to be sitting on the piles and the column going to be in the center. So the load from the structure going to go through the column onto the pile cap, and through the pile cap going to go down through the piles onto the ground. So that's very important. So this note is actually quite okay. And yeah, so we know the position now. So guys, I can also tell you this, that this designer actually showing us the as you can see, the plan view and the PC elevation, which is very good here. So what we know now, top of concrete, we know the slab level, we know the soffit of the slab. So maybe I just put it here quickly. Slab soffit equals actually 42,715. So I'm gonna be 42,715. This is very good information for us, especially when we're going to be doing the pile caps now. And what else we can do? So we got information about the height of this pile cap. So this is actually very, very easy and simple for us now, because this level now, the blinding level here, we're going to know, taking the 42,715 minus 1400, that's the blinding level, and obviously plus 75 mil, we're going to have our cutoff level here. And depends how much blinding we're going to put, but it's typically 50 mil. So our 42715 minus 1450 going to be our dig level for this particular pile cap. So that's very easy, guys. I think it's all clear. If you got any questions, just let me know. But in this case, it's very easy. All the pile caps are set at the same level. And as I said, you're going to be able to download more drawings. I'm going to let you see the drawings from the other designer, where there are going to be big differences. There are going to be some steps in the slabs. I want you to actually have a look through them. And if you got any questions, just come back to me, unless you want to see me making a video covering that drawing as well. So I think, guys, that will be all for today's video. We got all the information here. We got the drainage layout, pile caps layout. We got a basement GA, and combining them three drawings, we are good to go, really. And we got the soffit of the slab, we got our pile caps depth, we got the pile caps position, taking the columns position, we got the drainage, as I said. So I think that's all in today's video, guys. Just let me know, actually, if you like the way I'm showing this one compared to the capping beam videos. And obviously, if you got any questions, just, guys, leave the comments below. Ask me questions. No problem with that. I always answering them as soon as possible. And just don't forget to subscribe to my channel, guys. And yeah, see you next time.